Dang it. Wow, nice try, Mozzie. Get good, scrub, lol. Got him. Boom, roasted, and such. My five head. There's a path in there. Is it a dead end? It is? Golden nut! Another one of those receptor transmitter thingies. So the golden nut room isn't even on the map. Interesting. So I'm gonna really have to look outside the norm for to find those things. I feel that first one that I got was pretty well hidden too, to be honest. Shoot him in the butt. So you get a plate of Oreos? Is that even a question? I think Crixie is just trying to brag that she has Oreos and we don't. You can fit way more on a plate. You can fit way more on a plate. Stack them high. First thing I fought with a health bar, though. Man, I can't get the aim right. It's really hard. Nerd. In quarantine, and you only bought the essentials. Oreos. Yeah, I actually have to do... Well, I don't have to, but it's probably a good idea that I do some shopping tomorrow as well. The panic is starting to set in a little bit more over here. The hell is that?
Whew. Thought I was a goner this time. Some nano.
I was shopping last week, no problem.
Left the cages open again.
You could come down now.
Honestly, a gadget engineer deserves a bit more respect, if you ask me.
Yeah.
So, you are an inventor.
Gadget engineer. I create revolutionary devices for Executive Chairman Drek. For instance, Viola, my soon-to-be-patented grind boots. Look, I need to get out of here so I can find a new job. How about I sell you these? At cost.
Sell? After we just saved your scrawny butt?
All right, all right. I'll give you the employee discount, too.
I don't live in a very busy area.
Well, thanks. I'm going to get out of here while I
still
can.
So I probably will have... very easy time shopping with very minimal people there. It's not, the panic hasn't really set in that much. It's set in a little bit, but like, it's still fine here. There's not really a whole lot to worry about. But the thing is that I don't want to go out unless I absolutely have to. So I'd like to stock up on a little bit of stuff. I don't really need to. I have plenty here, but there's a couple things I would like to get, you know? Okay, I can just jump freely. I can jump and curve at the same time because I have grind boots, apparently. Which allow me to spin to move directions while jumping also. 24 rolls of Charmin should keep COVID away. Yeah, that's what I'm looking to get. Just 18 packs of toilet paper should cover my safety here. Pretty much most of the things are closed down around here too, yeah. Well, I got grind boots. Only thing I can do is win the grind tournament thingy, which is here. Chips are kind of like half non-perishable. They last for several weeks, so it's a good food to get. But I mean, it's not like it's a lot of content of food, you know? On jerky. Man, if jerky lasted more than like a tiny little bit of time, like jerky is not really much of a meal. It's more like a something that holds you over, a little bit of a snack. It is not a lot of value in terms of food for the price. I used to make my own jerky and I would like to get back into doing that. But even making it is pretty expensive and time consuming, but it's like about half the price of actually buying the jerky, so it's still better, but man, the amount of like food you get for the price, it's like, what is it, like $15 a pound or something like that for jerky on average, something ridiculous like that. It's absolutely absurd. I think it's actually way higher than that, I'm just forgetting, but yeah. I think it's 50, not 15. Something like that, like $40 to $50 a pound. But I can make it pretty cheap-ish, and it's kind of worth it like that. And it's good, it's better than store-bought too, for taste. Dying, I thought it'd be fine. And my wrench, my overhead wrench thing is not AoE. I thought it would be like a slam down thing, but it's not. Monka S. I mean, yeah, like, yeah, you know, you don't need hand sanitizer, by the way. Soap is also, you know, a means to wash your hands. BT dumps. And you can totally use soap to wash your hands. So hand sanitizer is only really necessary for when you go out. If you're going out, have some hand sanitizer available so when you touch things, you can use hand sanitizer. If you're at home, just wash your hands. It's really not that hard. Paracetamol is bad. What's paracetamol? I've never heard of paracetamol. Parasomatical. Paracetamol. Yeah, never heard of it. Is that? Is that aspirin? Yeah, I thought aspirin was acetaminophen. So if you get it, don't use Tylenol. I wouldn't use Tylenol anyway. I use ibuprofen for headaches and stuff and inflammation. Hey Derry, what's up? It's NSAID you want to avoid. So Tylenol's fine, but NSAID you want to avoid? What's NSAID? Is it NSAID in the membrane? NSAID in the brain? I'm NSAID, got no brain. Ibuprofen is an NSAID, you should avoid it. Oh! You want to avoid ibuprofen? Well, shit. Good thing to know that. Non-steroid, anti-inflammatory. So don't take ibuprofen. Got it. Well, good to know. Just remember the incubation period is 2 to 14 days. So if you've been outside in the last 2 weeks, you can still have it. So don't be taking ibuprofen at all. And continue to wash your hands. It's a war zone down here! Yeah, ibuprofen is my go-to as well. Mine? Glove. What do I not like? I don't really care for the... Where's the mic? Okay, I don't really care for the Doom Glove. What the hell? Oh! Mines! Ah! Right, of course! Mines! Mine glove! Yeah, okay. Now it makes sense. Hey guys, come over here and play. This is really cool. Every time I say a funny word, it's nails on a chalkboard. Like when I say library. I definitely say library on purpose, just so you know.
Rhino for your robot. Trade you.
Well, okay.
Ratchet.
I'm kidding. Sorry, he's not for sale. What's a rhino anyway?
Rip ya a new one.
What did you say to me?
R-Y-N-O. Rip ya a new one.
Why, that's the most powerful missile launcher in the galaxy. I know it's worth a lot of bolts. He must have stolen it from the Blarg.
Stolen? Look, trash can. Did I says anything about it being hot? You better watch your mouth or I'll...
Wait, don't tell me. Rip you a new one.
150,000 bolts! Bro! How about you bring that price down a little bit? I didn't say a bad word. When I said it, it was an accident. During the D&D session, that wasn't an accident. That was a slip of the tongue. When I was a slip of the tongue, it was a what do you call it? The thingy where you can't talk right and say words backwards and stuff. The thing, dyslexia. It wasn't a Freudian slip, because it's not like I was sitting there thinking dirty thoughts. It was 100% complete dyslexia. But that was on Finn's channel too, which made me feel a little bit better, or worse about it rather. Because it's someone else's channel and I accidentally said a really kind of vulgar word, which I don't really use, and it's actually not allowed in this channel in the chat. Like, swearing's fine, but vulgarity is not, you know what I mean? Like, say the F word, I don't really care. But, like, saying disgusting of, you know, things, yeah. We're not in grade school. Is it the rhino? Of course, it's expensive. Yeah, I mean, sure, but, you know, 150 seems like impossible. It almost feels like there's gonna be some kind of event that's gonna make him very, reluctant to want to sell it to me for that much anymore. So I'm thinking that maybe it'll come down and Flamethrower 2 OP though. Holy shit. Flamethrower is just so good. Minimal amount of ammo, maximum amount of devastation. That's the way. Correct. Yeah, exactly. That's another point, Papa. It's like the intent behind your words matters. And sometimes it's hard to convey exactly your point with text. Emotes help with that. Emotes do help. The only time Kappa doesn't help is when people try to get around, like, fan filters. It's like, I'm gonna say something really racist and then put a Kappa at the end of it, but it's obviously clearly a joke because I used Kappa, and it's like, nope, that doesn't work. That doesn't work like that. Oh god! So, I mean, you know, if it's something like that, then yeah. Love the flamethrower. No. I like this golden nut. It's more of like a trial, like a battle trial, than it is like find the secret thingy. So it's obvious there. All you gotta do is just get good scrub, and you get this one. Maybe. Maybe not. Oh, there it is. Oh man, what a debate, dude. There's a button in there, which means I probably have to approach it from up above or some kind of. Maybe it is a hidden thingy. Man, the game did a good job of debating me there. I seriously thought that, I mean, the fact that there's a button in there leads me to believe that it opens from the inside. Well played, game. Hey, Baraka, what's good, dude? Is that a giant cannon? That's a tank. It's a giant cannon printer! Stupid auto-targeting. Gosh dang it. The first-person controls are different, so it's kind of hard to get used to them. Just wait a little bit, it'll break on its own, right? I have not played Jak and Daxter, but just like these games, the Jak and Daxter games are also on the list. So if you wanted to vote for Dax and Jaxter, those are also available. Sly Cooper, yeah, I don't have those. I think they were a little expensive or something like that. I don't remember, because like what happened was I saw a speedrun on GDQ of Ratchet and Clank. I didn't see the whole thing, I just saw a part of it. And I was like, man, this game was like a lot of fun, and it's one of those games that I really missed out on. So I checked out the prices on eBay, and it was like $10 for the first four Ratchet games and the first four Jak and Daxter games, and I'm just like, or like all the PS4 versions of them. And I'm like, sure, why not? You know, I want to play these games and these are ultra cheap. Because games like this, these platformers and stuff, people typically play them, they do the stuff, and then they trade them in. And they're really, really well received, so they're popular, so there's a lot of them, so that their price is diminished greatly, very quickly after the release. So I was like, yeah, it seems like a cool opportunity to get a chance to play these, so, you know. That's what I did, and put them on the list, as I do with all my backlog games. Basically, all my backlog games are games that I wanted to play and never got around to, so I help have you help me decide what I play first, basically.
Welcome to the HoverCon Intergalactic.
But I never thought about Sly Cooper, really.
Captain Quark's giving away a brand new Platinum Zoomerator to the winner of this competition.
Wow.
A Platinum Zoomerator.
A Zoomerator.
Perhaps that will be the proof of your accomplishments that Skid's agent requires.
Wait. Do you guys mean Skid McMarks?
Yeah, Skid couldn't make it, so we're here to, you know, fill in for him.
Guess we'll see about that.
Was that jiggle physics? Really? Come on. Oh, okay, we're in here. We're just in here. Just End. It's like there's just no stopping. It's just boom, you're in the race. No tutorial, just figure it out. I mean, it's kind of pretty simple. Just press square to get a boost, and that's about it. Actually, I don't think you press square to boost. I think you gotta go through the rings to get a boost. Damn, well, I'm gonna lose. Man, if you make the jump, then you can't jump through the loop. If only there was like a way to like do half a jump. Almost. And then it just stops. It's like very awkward mini game. Not quite fully developed with menus and everything. It's just like blip. You know what's funny is despite its really kind of not super well built interface or anything, it's actually still really cool. And I'm enjoying it. And it's just kind of simple and whatever. Like, you don't need a bunch of da-da-da-da-da-da bullshit or losing jingles or anything. It just kind of pops you in. It's easy to understand right out of the gate. It would be nice to have at least had a countdown, though. That would have been nice. That sucked. I wasn't first. That's kind of brutal, dude. You can't make a single mistake or you don't get first. All right, whatever. Just don't mess up, LOL. To be fair, it's pretty clean. Okay. Pretty clean controls. For the most part. But it's kind of awkward how it just like throws you into it. Granted, it's nice because the game moves faster because of that, but would be nice to have, like I said, to have at least had a countdown or something like that.